I've just arrived after about an hour's drive, Brean on down. This place is amazing, look at it. I'm just on the car park here, and it's £5 parking all day, so I need to go over there and get a ticket or something. And I can see people walking up there, up the steps to the top. There's a cafe, I just paid £5 for the ticket here. What a wonderful beach. There's caravans all along this coastline. National Trust, Brean Down. Here we are, the top. You can play golf on here. But look at that beach. Feels really good. There's no safety net here. No safety net. You're on your own. What a place. This makes living every bit worth it. Look at it. Look at that beach. Looks humongous. These are the views we're talking about. It makes us feel like I want to go and make the most of every day for sure. Go as much adventures as possible, and this is the start. It's just incredible. Many more adventures planned. This is just a Kickstarter. This is what you call the beach. Probably the most incredible view of a beach I've ever seen. Bristol Channel. And look at all the seafront caravans. This is just a stunning, absolutely incredible view of this huge looking beach. Usually when you're high up, the beach looks small, but not this. This beach is looking the biggest piece of land all around me right now. Absolutely love it. You must get up here. When you're not adventuring, you get out of the feels for it. Right now I'm feeling the great feels, the great feeling, the almost euphoric feeling of adventure and why it's so special. I've got a new spark from the land. The adventure is back in me. The first trip is always the hardest. Once you're in motion, you just keep going to one place after another, and this feels like I've got some great momentum right in front of me, and I'm going to keep going. The route is quite simple, just follow this path to the end and come back on the other side of this peninsula and see the other side of the coast. So this is proving already to be one of the best walks that I remember. You know, I feel like my soul is filling up every few minutes up here. It's just wonderful. I can see an island in the distance. Bought it by the end, but there's still a fair way to go. Wow, look at this. The fort is down there. We've got a Spitfire, looks like. Going over that island, over the old fort. Let's go and investigate this old fort. Well, let's have a look around this piece of history. I feel like I'm in someone's palace, someone's castle. Spooky. And graffiti on the walls. look at that. And there's where the fire used to be. Wow. So much history. I love that. That is a cool window. Look at the view. And around in here, another fireplace over there. That is a big room. Down the steps is an underground magazine where the gunpowder was stored. The 100-pound barrels of gunpowder were lowered down using the pulley. The archway beside the pulley leads into the lamp passage. At the end, recess, the candles, oil burners were placed to light the gunpowder magazine. Well, look at this around. The sun just come out. It's stunning. Let's go and have a look. This magazine. Anybody in? Anybody home? Anybody home? I guess you're not supposed to go in there anymore. You really saw a lot, eh? Here we are in this huge room, the barrack room, 1870 to 1900. This is where the soldiers ate, slept, spent off duty hours. It was built to house 20 men, but for most of the time, only 4 or 5 guns lived here. Their beds opened out from the wall, doubling as chairs when folded up. It's hard to imagine, but originally soldiers' wives, children would have lived here too. So the beds were here by the walls that folded up. 20 people, 20 men, and the wives stayed here as well. 1940s, during the Second World War, the barrack room was used as a canteen leisure room. Soldiers slept in huts outside the fort. Serving hatch into the kitchen was for 1940s edition. You can see the steel roller for the shutter. Maybe it's that, yeah. And the steel roll shutters on the other side. Now this is where they put the food in. And the steel roll shutter is there. What a cool place. Let's go walk to the other rooms. Look at that view. Wow. As the old towers look like. Look at it. It's empty. Oh, they've got a window, of course, on the other side. This needs furnishing. It needs a roof. It needs furnishing. And it'll be a nice home. Solid build. It's when they really used to build houses to last. The gun emplacement, 1941. Wow, you can see how it used to be. It's a good place to explore. A bit of an outhouse over there. Ah, there's people already there. just chilling by the edge, looking at the water. It's been a nice look around. What's left of it? Check out my other adventures too. I've got other walks. I've got over 100 videos on this channel. And the best thing is, we haven't even started yet. This is just a warm up. You wait till I'm walking around New Zealand. I don't know when we'll get there. Walking around Queenstown, back to Australia, Thailand. It could be in 5 years. It could be in 10 years. We'll get there on this channel. For now, this is where I'm living, where I love, the good old UK. You know, some walks, you just feel like you want to do again. Most, you feel like once is enough. This walk definitely feels like I want to come back and do it again. This section over here, this coastline, is Weston-super-Mare. What a beautiful part of the UK. This is great, man. Really great. Weston-super-Mare coast and the road ahead. Looking good. As we look towards Weston-super-Mare, we see this building that looks like a jail. It's got some scaffolding holding it up. Could be converted into something. And we have this as well, more scaffolding. It looks like we have some points where the military would stand and guard the coastline. Our watch out points. But yeah, what a perfect view of Weston-super-Mare. Great view of the fields. I've got to say, I'm really happy to have done this. Very, very happy indeed. And please, I see the car park there. I see my car. I want to say, incredible walk. You know, you don't realise in the moment how incredible it is, how much good time when you've been in the moment, but maybe I'll look back at it and think, this was a great day, incredible. But for now, this is where this part of the video ends. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed it. Check out my playlist, the other videos. This is just the beginning of the adventure. Lots more to come. Peace. Oh, yeah. I'm ready for the sit down. I think what a nice, calm, peaceful place. Just a place to come. You know, we stayed in one of the caravans, just chill by the sea for a week or so. But yeah, it's a very nice, peaceful place. Until next trip, thanks for watching. Really appreciate it. Hope you enjoyed it. Cheers. See you next time.